This is Steve.
Hello.
He's an experiment.
Oh, I wonder how
a free thought experiment. His tracking plate. He has no original thought, and if he does, the thing in his ear shocks him. Primitive fellow, isn't he? He does have fun.
Yeah.
Well, except for those. As a unit, in the future, we like to test people like him. Especially to see if they have any free thoughts, or see if they run and free. But sometimes they can get loose. These experiments can cause insanity, chaotic actions. Why, yes, we feed him, but he throws it up at within 2 seconds. We provide entertainment. Sometimes he provides himself entertainment. There's nothing wrong with the cage he is in right now. There shouldn't be anything wrong with him. We like to watch him and make sure everything is okay. And nothing bad happens to him. But Steve wants escapism for some reason. As if to say, this cage isn't free. But this is the future. Freedom doesn't come naturally to others. But we watch him. Steve is trying to escape again. Oh, there he goes. He's like an animal, per se. We at the vicinity strive for those tasty to not have visual dots. We use them as experiments. Yes, they do get lonely. But of course. Everyone deserves a break in this vicinity. And so, they have a break of solidarity, in which Steve plays his trumpet. Beautiful sound when you listen to it closely. We like to look at AI the vicinity as his hopes and dreams incarnate. Because he knows he can never escape, or he can never be free. But after all, what is freedom? Thank you.
It has been one of the most hectic years, especially since the pandemic. These people here, my ride or dies, my best friends, we weren't able to hang out as much as we used to. So I decided to dedicate an entire video to them, showcasing our previous hangouts before the pandemic, and even some after. Without further ado, I present to you my friends.
Dragon Ball Z is easily the best anime ever.
Alright, so we have...
No. Who is that? Was that you?
No, I didn't even see what happened. What happened?
No, I don't like you. I mean, I'm not that mean of a guy, but to be honest, I would have found it very funny at the sandwich throwing if I was, what, in second grade? But certainly not now. Let this be a lesson to all of you. My wrath is unmatched! Okay, so I'm your substitute for the day. Unfortunately, Miss Pike isn't here today because she has been afflicted with a common cold. And unfortunately for me today, I had to cancel my yachting trip. So I'm gonna tell you a little bit about myself. I like to see myself as a very, very funny person. Look, I got a few jokes for you. Dare me. Triple damn dog dare me. Alright? Alright. Well, one yachtsman says to the other yachtsman, "Hey, can you please pass me a chocolate pudding?" And the second yachtsman says, "Hell no!" But the first yachtsman says, "Why not?" The second yachtsman says, "Well, it's against regulations to give a sailor man his dessert." Nothing? What about this one? I made this one up myself, and I think it's pretty clever. So I went out yacht buying, and, well, it was a good experience. To which my buddies asked me, which I do have many of them, "How was it like?" And I said, "Well, that dealer really had a hooked on me. And sales price." "Really? Nobody?" Well, of course you wouldn't get it. It has a lot of nautic materials that your little tiny brains don't get. Okay then, how about you make me laugh? And you'll find it very difficult.
Oh, Pete's got a good one.
What are you doing?
Okay, Pete, I would love to hear your joke.
Okay. Well, you see, there's these two cows on a pasture. One cow asks the other cow, "Have you heard of this mad cow disease that's been going around lately?" And the other cow says, "Yeah, I'm just happy that I'm a penguin." It's funny, because, you know, there's mad cow disease, and the cow thinks he's a penguin, so...
Remember when I said never speak unless spoken to? Well, I changed my mind. How about let's not talk at all. Alright, come on, you degenerates who don't know comedy.
Hey, excuse me. You two seen this joke?
Yeah, he was just... He's still in there.
Is he dangerous or something?
Okay, you just stay right here, Holmes. Hold it right there, Dumbo!
Hey, watch your tone, sir! I mean, watch your tone! Yo!
You know you're supposed to stay 500 yards from this school.
I don't know what you're talking about. Copper, you'll never take me alive. Ow! That's Dracula!
We found Mrs. Pike tied up in the lunch lady closet.
That sounds like a bad joke, I heard one.
Weird song, huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
So, are you gonna be at the puking park this weekend?
I don't know. I'm the uncoolest guy in the school.
Yeah, and there's that whole penguin problem again, huh?
I love the wisdom of the fully.
The ocean is a vast, mysterious place. We know less about our ocean than of space. There is also lakes, small and simple, yet seeming not brittle. But the most expressive are rivers, moving around the world in different ways. However, they lead back to the same source, together with the ocean. Maybe it's a metaphor for life and its many complications. But just like life, with all of its mistakes and pathways, it goes back together. Rivers are pathways, that's to understand. But like life itself, it isn't easy to comprehend. It moves around and around, and we end up back together to the beginning and to the end, to the source. Like rivers.
coronavirus presents a public health emergency in the United States. Quite simply, stay at home.
100,000 deaths from COVID-19.
Deadliest year in U.S. history.
They can't play with friends. They're not in school.
Happy birthday to you.
For young ones, it feels like their life as they know it is lost. March 19th, the stay-at-home order went statewide.
Valerie, you have 12 missing assignments.
It's hospitals filled with COVID patients.
12 missing assignments.
The U.S. hits 200,000 COVID deaths.
For some of you, this is probably how your year went by. I know for myself, it was very stressful and hard to focus on just simple homework when the world was in chaos all around us. 589,000 people lost their lives to COVID in the US. 589,000 families lost a loved one, myself included. But if you're watching this, then it means you're alive. And as odd as that may sound, it's something to be very grateful about. If going through all this has taught us anything, it's to appreciate more. We have access to vaccines now, cases have gone down. We're starting to see the light at the end of the tunnel. I'm grateful to get out of my house and finally go outside. I'm grateful to just be alive, live another day, make new memories.
Hold me like it's the very last time, at least for tonight. Pull my hair and kiss my head, and we'll get high. Skinny dipping from the Santa Monica Pier. Sign our names into the sand so we remember. We felt an enemy in the middle of midnight, me, you, my heart, and the Hollywood sign. Breaking out of my just to tell it, we're stupid, we're doing anything we can just to feel something, just to feel something, just to feel something. Got no plan, doing anything we can just to feel something. Only got 12 hours in the late, no time to waste. Why don't we both push past the pain so we can say we failed to be me in the middle of midnight, me, you, my honor, and the Hollywood sign. Making out a mall and drive, barely made it out alive, crashed my car on the sidewalk. We're selfish, we're melting, we're talking shit just to tell it. We're stupid, we're doing anything we can just to feel something. Just to feel something, just to feel something. Got no plan, doing anything we can just to feel something. Just to feel something. Just to feel something. Got no plan, doing anything we can just to feel something.
Hello? Are you hurt?
Yes. Yeah, I'll be safe.
Yes, I'm half a mile away. Did they give you food and water? Yeah, I'm almost there.
Okay, love you too.
We interrupt this program. This is a national emergency. A nuclear attack was commenced against the United States. 15 nuclear bombs have...
Ethan?
I'm sorry, Jesse. There's only enough supplies for one of us.
In today's day and age, the feat of natural disasters has become all too normal. Regardless of massive hurricanes or raging wildfires, the ever-deteriorating state of the planet has left many believing that climate change is not an important enough issue to discuss. This, however, is wildly untrue, as naturally, these tragedies have impacted the younger generation across the nation, and we wanted to know the various effects that climate change has had on these adolescents by asking them a series of questions on how natural disasters has impacted them. How has a natural disaster affected your schooling?
I feel like it's affected it a lot, specifically with what we learn in class. Teachers have been trying to teach us more about what's going on around the world regarding climate change, so more class time is spent on that.
Would you say that climate change has impacted the way you grew up?
For sure. You know, as a generation, we're very active on, you know, things that are currently going on, current events, so climate change has been a really big part of my life, and I'm very aware of everything that's going on around the world.
Are natural disasters a common worry for you?
Definitely. Even personally, with me living in Miami, Florida being, you know, prone to flooding and a lot of hurricanes, we're always worried about, hurricanes, tropical storms, and preparing for the worst to happen, and just electricity cutting out too.
Would you say that the frequency of natural disasters is normalized for you?
Yeah, I mean, you know, we always like joke about natural disasters, oh, like hurricane parties, making memes about it. But, you know, these natural disasters are, you know, very serious, and we shouldn't make fun of it as much as we do.
Are you or anyone you know in immediate housing danger from natural disasters?
Thankfully, me or just anyone I know is in no danger. However, it's always a conscious effort that we put in when looking for houses here with the flooding or with trees or wires. So it's always, we're always thinking about the worst case scenario.
Hi, I'm Carlos Monge. I'm an advisor for the Natural Resource Governance Institute. Climate change is really, really important. Global warming is imperiling, threatening the life of humanity as we know it. Nevertheless, against what science says, governments and companies are planning to increase the production and consumption of oil and coal. This needs to stop now. We need a global agreement to change course now.
opportunity for growth. It's an opportunity to teach us that we need to start taking care of our environment, and that it's an important, just as important as taking care of our families and our homes and our cars and our jobs and our health. Taking care of the climate is as important as that too.
We need to call upon our government and demand change. We need to implement eco-friendly legislation and actually help our environment on a large scale. We need to start making change today to impact everyone's tomorrow.